tit-bit nipply this morning. But boy, that old beast fires right up. That old beast fires right up. And look at that. Nick's even washing windows. He's going to make somebody a good housewife someday.
With this 2160, we were fortunate enough to have it for the fall season so we could run it and see what kind of issues arose prior to going through it over the winter.
'Tis the season. Everything's full. Early start for tomorrow.
We hauled grain with this tractor all fall, and then we threw it on the disc chisel to see how she pulled and if any oil leaks would show up or any other surprises would come up before I threw it in the shop for the winter. We put brand new rubber on the tractor, and as you can see, the rear fenders were really faded. And the hood was starting to turn white as well. So it was in desperate need of a paint job. Bought it with the anticipation that we were going to do this project to this one as well and have a matching tractor.
Like this. The same color as that. So I'm under the hood of this 2160 Buhler Versatile, and it's kind of funny. They painted them red over all the blue hoods. That's New Holland blue underneath the red. And it's in a lot of different spots on this tractor. You can see it down there. You can see it back there a little bit. Right here quite a bit. So they were originally blue. Let's take them back and make them blue again. I'm all right with that. Vacuumed out the cab of this tractor with a large shop vac that you plug in. Well, since then, I got smart. Found myself a nice little Milwaukee one here. That's M18 batteries. We're going to vacuum this cab out with this thing because it's a lot more portable. We're going to do a much better job. And I'm smarter now. So I've been wondering where my 12 millimeter socket's been. 12 or 13. Haven't been able to find it since a while ago. Guess what? It's right there. It's been up in the hood of this tractor, up in the roof, ever since I put the beacon light on. Here I thought it was in my truck somewhere, and I dug through my truck 5-6 times trying to find this damn socket. Nope, it's in the roof of the tractor. You wait long enough, you find everything you lose, right, hon? We'll be right back. So I found when we're prepping the panels, sandpaper works, but one of these hard green pads does a great job of scarifying the surface for the primer to attach. So here we've got one of the panels. All you gotta do is get on there and rub circles, and look what happens. Kids, don't do this to your mom and dad's car. They will beat your butt. But this is all you have to do, and you're good to go before you gotta wipe it down. Notice this tractor came from Painter, New Holland. And that was Monmouth, Illinois. That's pretty cool. So I'm going to show you how I find most of the parts I need for these tractors, and we're also going to give a little plug for Messix here, because they make it really easy to find it. Go to their webpage, scroll down to their equipment parts, click on whatever you're looking for, and we're looking for New Holland, right? So it'll pop up a menu, click on that, we're going to type in 8770, and then we'll go over, we'll hit enter, and you'll get all that pop up. Now we're working on an A, so we're going to click on that. We don't want the engine. We want to find front axle. So front axles and steering, come down here. We want to find our front axle adjustable two-wheel drive right at the top. And up pops this wonderful exploded view that will pull up into range. And over here is your part numbers. So we looked at part number 3 and part number 4 here. We put those in the tractor. So part number 3 over here is a seal. There's your part number. If you want to order it from a Versatile Buhler dealer, the replaced number 865031333, there is a very good chance, 90% chance, that is the part number through Versatile Buhler. And instead of paying $65 through a New Holland dealer, you're probably looking at 30 to 40% less on the majority of these parts ordered through a Versatile Buhler dealer. So anything on these tractors you get through New Holland, you can get through Versatile Buhler, and they tend to drop ship them within a couple days. So if you're not in a huge hurry, there's some savings to be had. And you can also get a good look at how things are supposed to go back together. A little smarter this time around, I'm wearing gloves. We'll be right back.
that's a start. So now we get to do the fun part. We get to start laying down some paint. Start out priming it, and shouldn't have any issues with any of that. Ready to go. And then we get into the black, and then the blue. This morning we are shooting the blue today, so I'm taping everything off, and of course Corey, I'm going to wipe everything down really well, rust, to get rid of the fisheye and avoid that whole problem. But we are very close to mixing up a batch of blue and shooting the moon. To make really sure we got this taped off well. We had some fisheye problems in the black over there, so I'm going to wipe all of this down one more time with a heavy duty wax grease remover. Make sure there is no imperfections on this, so this paint takes. We're doing a two stage this time. We're going to shoot a base coat, which is a 1-to-1 blend with a reducer. So we want to put on 6 to 8 light coats, and we're going to go left to right, and then we're going to go up and down. We're going to cross hatch this so that you don't see spray paint lines in this metallic, just like we did last time. But then, once it's flash dried, we come back in after that last coat, we put on some clear coat, and 2 to 3 coats of that, you gotta be very careful so that doesn't run. It'll be mixed with a hardener, 4-to-1 if I remember right, double check my paperwork, and that'll give us that really sharp, glossy final finish that really make this one pop. Start where nobody's going to see your mistake. So I'm going to start on the top of the roof where nobody's going to see my first mistake.
Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys. it sound right, boys. Sound right, boy.
Oh, I can hardly breathe in here. It's pretty fumey, but that's the day. Thank you. Now, if I put everything in a video that I wanted to put in a video, this thing would be probably 4 hours long. So we're gonna have just a little bit more of the 8970 we did for my dad's, and then we're gonna do some group photos. All done. So take a look at the traditional blue. Let me know what you think of that. What's your favorite? Leave it in the comments.
Thank you.